marine debris is anything human-made that gets into our streams, rivers, lakes, and ocean.
While there are many types of marine debris, we already found something scary in our water. Not sea monsters, but plastic.
When studying our local Thunder Bay River, we were shocked to find plastic in our water.
How did these plastic monsters get here?
What happens when they enter our Great Lakes and ocean?
What can we do to help?
Let's find out.
How did these plastic monsters get into our water?
Just a soda and apple, please. Would you like a bag?
Yes, please.
That'll be $2.
Here you go.
This plastic bag could get into our Great Lakes and ocean in many different ways.
A plastic bag can be carried by the wind to a local stream or river. A plastic bag can also float to a storm drain. Through the storm drain, this bag often flows to a local stream or river.
Once the plastic gets here, it can flow to our Great Lakes and eventually make its way to the ocean.
So what happens when these plastic monsters get into our water?
With sunlight and UV radiation, or heat from the sun, these plastic monsters break down into smaller and smaller pieces.
We did some research and found out that plastics underwater absorb toxins like DDT, PAH, and PCBs.
Plastics can enter our food web when eaten by plankton, which are eaten by tiny fish.
Which are eaten by bigger fish. Eventually, we could eat these fish.
What can you do to help stop these plastic monsters?
Reuse! Here's some ways to refuse single-use plastics.
While at a restaurant, always say no straw, please.
Right, and you can always refuse to-go containers by bringing your own.
And when shopping, remember to use reusable bags and avoid the plastic bags.
Reuse!
If you can't refuse, then reduce or use less single-use plastics.
While shopping, purchase items with less plastic packaging. Buy items in bulk if you can.
Instead of single-use water bottles, bags, and to-go containers, go reusable!
By reusing items again and again, we limit the amount of plastics that enter our water. If you do use single-use plastics, get creative and reuse them any way you can.
Recycle!
If all else fails, recycle any single-use plastics.
But be sure to check your community's recycling rules first for what you can and can't recycle.
We hope you enjoyed learning about plastic and how it impacts our Great Lakes and ocean. Now, take action. Refuse to single use and help us spread the word.
Spread the
opinion.
Science.
Science.
Action.
Scene 2, take 4. Action.